can't believe we're playing cards again. It seems like we're playing it all the time. What are you doing biology lately?
Oh, well, actually, we're starting a new unit on ecology this week.
Well, that sounds very interesting, doesn't it, Maggie?
Yeah.
So, I think we're starting a unit on circles. Do any of you guys happen to know what the definition of a circle is?
I don't know.
I don't know.
What?
Was that Jenny, you know?
Oh, a circle is a set of all points equidistant from a single point on a two-dimensional plane.
I get it. The single point is the center. Let's put the center right here. And the equidistance is the radius.
So today you're going to talk about tangents. I know we've talked about it before in class, so this is kind of a review of something that we did before we left for this pandemic. In any event, we talked about a tangent line. Tangent line is a line that hits a circle one time. Now that's kind of hard. If the line is infinite, this is a bad representation of a line because it stops here and stops here. So, but if the line's infinite, it seems like a line would have to hit a circle twice. It'd have to like come into the circle and then go out. But a tangent line only hits it once because it kind of skims the circle. So it kind of just hits it like that and comes and just kind of skims the circle like that. And that point right there is called the point of tangency. So we're going to look at a couple properties about the properties of tangencies, one of which is the relationship between a tangent line and a radius. So tangent line and a radius. Joey, come here. So this is the radius, this is the tangent line. Look how they intersect. What do you notice?
They
do touch each other. That means they intersect. They intersect each other in a special way. Maggie, you know how they intersect?
Perpendicular.
They are totally perpendicular. And we learned that before we left. But that's always going to make a right angle. Something else you need to know about tangents is when you have two tangents. So if you have one tangent line like this, and a second tangent line like this, to the same circle, and notice they're coming from the same exterior point, they're always going to be congruent to each other. So that means this distance here, from here to the circle, is going to be the same as the distance from this external point to the point of tangency. And those are the two properties of tangents we're going to go over today in those notes. I'll see you in the notes.